In the scene that follows, Golo tells Pelias that he knows the sort of nonsense he witnessed was mere child's play, but it must stop. Melisande is delicate, is in fact about to have a child, and there must be no recurrence. He has noticed something between Pelias and his wife, and it must not continue. This confrontation sets us up for one of the most disturbing scenes in this disturbing opera. Golo will use his young son to spy on the two lovers. Imagine a spot in front of the castle with a window just above head height. Golo enters below with his little son and tells him they are going to watch what goes on in the forest. "Why, look," he says in this next extract, "we are under the very room of your little mother. Maybe she is saying her prayers. Tell me, son, is she often in the company of your uncle Pelias?" "Yes, petit père, daddy." "When you are not here," the boy replies.
"Tiens, nous sommes tout juste assis sous les fenêtres de petite mère. Elle fait peut-être sa prière du soir en ce moment. Mais dis-moi, mignonne, elle est souvent avec ton oncle Pelléas, n'est-ce pas?"
"Oui, oui, toujours, petit père, quand vous n'êtes pas là."
The scene grows in menace as Golo questions what his wife and Pelléas do when they are together. "Why do they not want the door open?" he asks, for example, all the while trying to console and bribe the child with inducements of presents.
"Voyons, pourquoi pleures-tu maintenant? Est-il arrivé?"
"Oh, oh, petit père, vous m'avez fait mal."
"Je t'ai fait mal? Où t'ai-je fait mal? C'est sans le vouloir."
"Ici, ici, à mon petit bras."
"C'est sans le vouloir, voyons, ne pleure plus. Je te donnerai quelque chose demain."
"Quoi, petit père?"
"Un carquois et des flèches. Mais dis-moi ce que tu sais de la porte."
"De grandes flèches?"
"Oui, de très grandes flèches. Mais pourquoi ne veulent-ils pas que la porte soit ouverte?"
To modern sensibilities, this abuse of the father-son relationship, spiritually and physically, is as disturbing as anything in The Turn of the Screw. Towards the end of the scene, Golo lifts the boy onto his shoulders to look into the room. Is she alone? No, Uncle Pelias is there. Are they close together? What are they doing? The undertow of impending gloom develops into towering rage as the scene ends and the orchestra depicts Golo's anxiety and inner turmoil.
"Regarde! Regarde, mignonne! J'ai trébuché. Regarde, que font-ils?